And now let's see. Oh wow, this is one-handed. That's amazing. Grab it this way. One hand.
What up guys, Adrian from YouMotorcycle. I'm in my garage and I'll be honest. It's a friggin' mess in here. There's a lot of stuff, there's a lot of bikes. But there is one thing that I really like in terms of using my garage space, which is great in a big space or even if you have a much smaller space, is this Dolly right here. Because it lets me kind of just stick bikes really close together, put them in the corners, put them in places where you wouldn't naturally be able to just walk a bike. And even though it's a huge garage, having a motorcycle dolly helps me save a ton of space. There's just one problem, which is this dolly, it's your kind of your standard size one. It'll fit most street bikes. It'll fit a small size cruiser. It will not fit a really big cruiser like my Harley Davidson V-Rod, which is why you need the big dolly. This is the Black Widow aluminum motorcycle dolly. It's like their heavy duty, serious, not messing around dolly. Now I'm assuming if you're watching this, you're probably interested in potentially buying a motorcycle dolly. I'm gonna cover what is in the box, how easy it is to put it together, and how well it actually works. All right, so part one is gonna be actually just unboxing this thing and seeing what we get in the box. Check that out. Everything just like fits in nice and perfect. You can tell that it's really thought out. Looks super clean. So far, so good. And it does look like there are really good instructions in here, which is great. One thing that I commented when I did the review of my Discount Ramps motorcycle table lift was that they actually had instructions that were in like perfect English and made sense, and all the pieces and everything was accounted for. This again looks super easy to follow, so that's encouraging too. So that's really all there is to it in terms of unboxing. So I'm gonna just go ahead and take a quick look at the instructions here. Maximum weight capacity is 1500 pounds, which is way bigger than any motorcycle I'm gonna throw on it. I'll make sure that everything is included in here, because they give you a list of parts, even nice big pictures of what to look for and what the quantities of each one are, so that's awesome. All right, so let's do the assembly part now. Basically, they want you to take your bracket, your double hole thing, grab an M10x30, a lock washer, and just a normal washer, and put it through on the outside, going outwards, so essentially like that. And you're gonna grab your M10, your washer, and your crust washer, put them through here. And doing this 10 times is literally all step one is. Done. For step 2A, pretty much the same setup. This time you're gonna grab your single hole, put it through there. And you got your bolt with your lock washer and your washer, put that up and in. For part 2B, I'm gonna grab hex bolt, washer, and should go just like this with the remaining bracket. Then you're gonna grab your lock nut and lock that in there. Step 3, pretty straightforward. That goes together. And from the top, you're gonna use the big 40 to hold it in there. And from the bottom, you're just gonna hold the nut in place. So we get this in here. And then, hold on tight to that. Tighten that up. All right, so the next step is to just basically slide this into here. And then as it travels along, once you get it to where you want it, you just tighten these up. And the only thing to keep in mind is the instructions do say it's gotta be a minimum of 10 inches from the end. So we're gonna go to just past here, tighten that up, and we're gonna do that with all of the other pieces. All right, so assembly done. Let's see how well this thing actually works. That's pretty easy. So right off the bat, two things I gotta admit I really love about that is these casters are huge. They are like multiple times bigger than the little tiny casters you get on the little cheap dollies. These things are huge, which means that they've gone over bumps and stuff in the garage super easily. They're great. Yes, it does seem like this kind of tips up a little bit when you first go on it, but not that big of a deal. I'm sure I could make a little ramp or a stopper if I really wanted to, or put this end up against a wall. What else? What I loved going on this which I don't have, which you don't get on the little cheaper dollies, is this is so nice and wide. And I have a big 180 rear tire, and the V-Rod later years actually come with a 240 rear tire. This thing is so big, you could easily fit a 240 rear tire on there, maybe even a 300 rear. The only thing left to test is how well can I just spin it around. And again, I'm not in like good footwear, I'm in flip-flops, guys. So let's see how well I can spin this around just in my, basically my beach wear.
4, 5, and now let's see. Oh wow, this is one-handed. That's amazing. Grab it this way. One hand. And I'm not like a big, like 7 foot tall linebacker one-handed. I'm like 5'10 and a half, 5'11. I weigh like a buck 60, buck 65. And I can push this thing around like nothing. Let me try and get a different angle so you can see. One finger. Again, one finger. Okay, I might need 2 fingers this time. One foot.
Very little wasted space. If I didn't have the extensions on my Black Widow, these two bikes would be like nice and pretty much touching. That's exactly what I wanted. I love that with one hand, I can just pull this back out if I need to get in there to work on a bike. And then with one hand, I can just push it back in again. So we should probably talk final thoughts on this. Taking out the box, I mean, as soon as I opened the box, I'm like, okay, this is quality. Took it out, everything looked beautiful. Assembly was easy. Once again, Black Widow has instructions that are in plain English that are easy to follow, that have pictures. It just makes life so much easy. They also give you the hex keys, so you can totally assemble it yourself, even if you don't have that many tools, so that was great. This is definitely a great space saver. If you're gonna have a single car garage where you wanna have, you know, be able to put your bike right up against the wall and still be able to fit a car between, you know, in the garage space, it's great. Or if you're just like me and your garage is just a clusterfuck of motorcycles, something like this is awesome. It's a lifesaver. Is it worth more than these little cheap dollies? Yeah, 100%. I could never get a bike like my V-Rod, let alone a big Decker or a big Honda Fury or anything that's big on something dinky like this. This thing gets caught up all the time. If there's even like a little pebble, it'll get caught between these tiny little tires versus those giant casters. Look at the size of those things. Those things are huge, they're great, I love them. And they go over everything, those are awesome. Really, really love the quality of the finish. The fact it's aluminum means it's not gonna discolor, it's not gonna rust, it's not gonna get all pitted and crappy looking. This is something that like, you're gonna buy it once and you're never, ever, ever gonna have to replace it. So that's pretty cool. This is the good stuff right there. The fact that these things pivot so well, so smoothly, you could actually, when I had it upside down, I could see the bearings inside there. They looked really good quality. The fact that I can move my bike around with one finger, like, come on. What more could you ask for? This thing is perfect. The only real knocks I have on the product are the casters do take up a little bit more space. I don't know if they need to stick out this far because you do lose a few inches here and on the other side. However, on this little one you don't, but on this little one, god damn, like it is just, it gets caught on stuff all the time and it doesn't stick out as much, sure, but geez, like it's, oh my god, it's, and it, if there's bumps, if there's like little dents like this in your cement, that's not even that deep, this thing will get caught and it gets really awkward. So I can't complain too much about the casters taking up the extra few inches. Overall, this is just a really good looking product. Again, it's not my only Black Widow product from Discount Ramps. I got the table from them. I have a jack, there it is, that's also from them. Those of you who know my channel, you guys know I am a pretty picky guy. I've been motorcycle riding for like 10, 15 years. So if there is a brand that I keep going back to, it's good shit. Overall, I'm giving this product like a 4.8 out of 5. Only thing that's really lacking is maybe a little bit of like a little lip to make it a little bit smoother getting onto the platform. That's not really a big deal. That's really just me picking, so this doesn't seem like Adrian just says everything is perfect. It's not. It's a product. They all have things that people like more or don't like. But realistically, I can't really ask much more from this. It's awesome. And like I said, it's something that's going to last a lifetime. Anyway, if you want more motorcycle content from a guy who has too many motorcycles, please hit subscribe. Check out my next videos. Check out my other videos on my channel. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. I spent a lot of time on this video, so I'd really appreciate your support. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, ride safe, but have fun. Peace.